Hey guys, this is my DSP final project. For this, I'm going to do a phase vocoder, and basically what that's going to do is it's going to allow us to take a signal, an audio signal, and mess around with its frequency spectrum, scale it any way we want to, but in the time domain, it's going to run for the same amount of time. So the first thing I'm going to show you is a plot in the frequency spectrum of an Obama speech next to a plot in the frequency spectrum of a Thatcher speech, and in the background, you're going to hear the original Thatcher speech.
Close to the 40th anniversary of that service and of peace in Europe, one of the longest periods without war in all our history.
So we see over here that the frequency content is centered at a higher frequency than the Obama one. We're going to try and pitch shift it down so it sounds a little more like a male voice talking. And we're going to do that using a phase vocoder. And what that's going to do is it's going to take the signal in the time domain and break it up into a bunch of bins that like overlap each other, so a bunch of little snapshots of it. And we're going to Hanning window all of them. So that number one, when we mess around with the frequency content, when we do the FFT, we're not going to get like a hard cutoff at the ends like a rectangular window would do that would mess around with the frequency spectrum. And we're not going to get, when we combine them all at the end, it'll sound a little better. So we're going to do those FFTs. We're going to mess around with the phase a little bit so that when we scale it all out, the phases won't get messed up in between each of those FFTs. And when we do the inverse FFT, we're going to spread all of those out a little further than we did when we did the original FFT. And what that's going to do is it's going to retain the original frequency spectrum, like the FFT and the IFFT will return the same frequency spectrum, but it's going to shift it all down in the time domain so that it runs faster, but it has the same frequency content. We're going to hear what that sounds like right now.
Close to the 40th anniversary of that service and of peace in Europe, one of the longest periods without war in all our history.
So you heard that. It ran a little faster, definitely, but frequency content sounded the same. And the reason it sounded the same was that we were using the old sampling frequency. But what would happen if we were to scale the same sampling frequency by the same ratio that we used to like mess around with the frequency spectrum? Well, over here you can see, here's the original Thatcher speech right here. Here's the Obama speech down here. And if we scale our sampling frequency, we get a frequency spectrum that kind of looks like this. It's all been shifted down, but it retains the same qualities. So what would that sound like if we were to play it out loud?
Close to the 40th anniversary of that service and of peace in Europe, one of the longest periods without war in all our history.
So yeah, it sounded pretty good. It sounded pitched down. It definitely doesn't sound like a male voice. That's due to these things called formants, which don't scale at the same ratio that a human voice does. It would take a much more complicated algorithm to run something like that. But this sounds pretty good, I thought. And if you have any questions, let me know. Thanks.